Hillsborough Castle and Gardens has been transformed both inside and out. Over the past 5 years, historic royal palaces have worked with a number of specialist craftspeople to really elegantly and beautifully restore the castle on the inside, but also to transform and reimagine the gardens as well for visitors to enjoy.
The grounds at Hillsborough extend to 98 acres on this site, and then we also look after the grounds of the fort across the road, so 110 acres in total. You come in first of all to the walled garden, and that opens out in front of you with the beautiful double herbaceous borders leading up to the pavilion in the centre.
This walled garden has undergone a total reimagination. The layout is modelled on the original layout from plans from the beginning of when the walled garden was originally built. There's so much here to see in this 4 acre space in the walled garden. There's such a range of crops, from heritage varieties to the more modern equivalents.
It's designed to be both ornamental and productive. So we're producing vegetables and fruit for use by the Yellow Door Cafe.
And the chefs come out and harvest it, and a couple of hours later, at the very most, it has been served on the plate. So it's, you don't get much fresher than that.
The rooms within the castle were all represented, particularly the throne room and the drawing room. We removed each of the pieces off the collection and then allowed the contractors to come in, whether they were gilders, whether they were polishing the floors, whether they were painting. Once the rooms had been handed back to us after the representation, it was my duty to actually take each piece of the collection and reinstall it into the rooms, along with my colleagues from London.
We have art here on loan from the Royal Collection, the Shaw Collection, the Victoria and Albert Museum, National Museums Northern Ireland, really significant pieces of art. For instance, the throne room, the themes of the art there look at rule and power and law and justice. We also have the red room, which has a very dense cabinet hang of highly decorative, smaller, intimate pieces of art. To contrast with that, we also have a really interesting collection of contemporary Ulster art that represents the taste of the royal family, including both His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales and Queen Elizabeth the Queen Mother, who herself was a very avid collector of Irish art. We are introducing a number of particular guided tours that focus on the art, royal histories and political histories.
In addition to the transformation that took place at the castle itself, we have added a brand new lower visitor facility to our offering here at Hillsborough Castle. Within the Lower Visitor Centre, we have a brand new restaurant and coffee shop and a new retail space as well. So it really is a destination in of itself. And on the upper site, we have a new stable yard and tea room and learning space as well. So we work with a number of people from the local community, and they get to come into the Clore Learning Facility, which is the first of its kind in Ireland.
It's a fantastic resource where we have three learning spaces where we can not only provide curriculum linked sessions for schools from Key Stage 1 right the way through to A level, but we also have a space for adult learning, for family learning. We program regularly family events in the garden so that families can discover what grows here, who lives here in the woods and the streams, in the glen.
Now we're open for everybody to come and really, really enjoy the space. We spent a lot of time and energy making a really friendly environment for people to enjoy. The team are a great bunch, so no matter what weather you come into Hillsborough Castle, it could be raining down, but our guys are all about making you feel really welcome and at home within the castle and sharing all of their magical knowledge that they have about our castle and about our grounds.